Typically, you could furnish several homes with the remains of a very big day at Daytona International Speedway. 500 fans get very comfortable and sometimes leave behind the comforts of home. What an odd sight, an entire living room set, matching, thank you very much, nothing more than trash now. The infield is a landfill, complete with scavengers the day after. Couches, lawn furniture, what appear to be perfectly good grills, discarded. The cleanup teams have seen it all.
More trash than I ever realized in my life.
Just goes on and on.
Just goes on and on.
Couches, maybe lawn furniture. I mean, I never seen a kitchen sink yet, but I figured they'd go ahead and bring it in.
The trail of debris is a dream for plastic and aluminum recyclers. Thanks to Bud and the boys, though no longer cold ones, the cans are piled high. When the infield beds down, they do it in fine style. And what they can't see trackside, they watch on TVs. But who needs any of it anymore?
They leave their whole setups behind. They build houses out here and they leave the whole damn house behind.
Scaffolding for a better view is carefully built, then tossed aside, enough to fuel plenty of campfires, which, by the way, we found still burning here and there. What comes into the track doesn't always go out the same way. The infield actually looks a lot better than it has in previous years. Visitors better at cleaning up after themselves, and the Speedway has this cleanup thing down to a science. What we have seen more of are race fans, apparently a little reluctant to leave. At Daytona International Speedway in Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.